Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Owen Center here in Peoria, Illinois. It's Bradley Braves Hockey on the Bradley Hockey YouTube channel. Tonight, the Bradley Braves taking on the St. Louis Billikens. The D2 team, of course, taking on the St. Louis Billikens in their home opener here at the Owen Center. Should be a great contest tonight. Alongside Jack Simzyk, I'm Matt Harrington. Jack, it's good to have you in the booth.
Matt, it's good to be back this season. Home opener here in the Owen Center. A crowd is still filing in. It is packed up. I'm pumped up, ready to go. How about you?
I am very excited. This is a date I've had circled on my calendar for
some
time, and we're going to have a lot of fun here tonight at the Owen Center. The crowd's starting to file in. We've got a lot of Bradley students that were coming out to this game tonight, and it was kind of the talk on campus throughout the whole week.
Oh, yeah. You know, you walk around campus and the student center and all that, Bradley players out there selling shirts, tickets. It's all over the place. And you love to see it. This program has grown so much in my time here over the past 3 years. And it shows tonight with this crowd. They're ready to go.
So we will have the full team introduction from PA announcer Mitch Kaminsky once we get a little bit closer to game time. And we will have that on the microphone for you as well. We're going to have the starting lineups as well, I believe, for Bradley. And then you'll hear the starting lineups as well for St. Louis. But, Jack, we've got a good one tonight, and we do know the starting goaltenders for tonight's game. We're going to have both of those pop up here on the screen for you. Let's take a look at those starting goaltenders tonight.
Well, yeah, in goal tonight for St. Louis, we got Cole Kessner. Here we go. Cole Kessner last year only played six games. St. Louis's starting goaltender, Alec Dirks, who played most of their games last year, he is gone, and now St. Louis has three different goaltenders. Kessner had the most experience, six games played last year, a save percentage of .857, and he played a total of 270 minutes. So he's got a little more experience than the other two, but it'll be a good start for him. And then the Bradley Braves, we have the always reliable Joshua Soule in net tonight. Soule is returning from last season after posting a 3.93 goals against and a .874 save percentage after going 8-7.
Yeah, Soule, certainly no question about it. He improved a lot last year, I think, from where he was at the start and to where he is now. So it'll be impressive to see how he performs tonight. In the meantime, we're going to go ahead and take a look at those keys to the game in just a moment. It's going to be a fun one. I'm really excited, no question about it. It's going to be a fun one, no question. Let's go ahead and take a look at those keys to the game. Take us through these, Jack.
All right, keys to the game tonight for St. Louis. You got to stay disciplined. You're on the road. This crowd's going to be rocking. You don't want to get off to a shaky start. Next key is get that first goal. And this lines up right with the third key. You get that first goal, you get the crowd out of it, adapt to the crowd. And then we got for Bradley, they got to feed off this crowd energy. Obviously, we've been talking crowd, crowd, crowd all night. Get physical. That gets the crowd riled up, too. And then finally, pepper the net. Like we said, Kessner inexperienced tonight in goal. You get your shots on net, I'm sure some are going to trickle through, especially with the shaky nerves, the away game, the riled up Bradley crowd here. Those are your keys to the game for St. Louis and Bradley tonight.
It is going to be a fun one, no question about it. And we're going to have both teams start to come onto the ice here in just a moment. If you've noticed, we've improved our graphics a lot here. We're trying out some new things in terms of things disappearing on the screen, and you'll see these keys to the game fade off your screen in just a minute. But we've got a new scoreboard. We're doing replay this year.
I'm excited.
I'm really excited for that. I think that's going to be, I think as a color commentator, that's going to be a huge
help. Definitely helps me out. I can now see what just happened again as I talk about it. You know,
right.
Some people don't know, but it's hard out there. Players score. You can't see names, assists. We now get replays. That also helps for tough calls, like penalties. You're not quite sure what they are, whether a goal crossed the goal line, whatever. We have more updated technology here in the Owen Center. Let me tell you, it's about time.
And we are, in case anybody's wondering what we're using this brand new thing called Sling Studio. And I've used this before with some of the other hockey announcing that I've done. And it is just completely a game changer. No question about it. All kinds of graphic stuff you can do. You can do replay. I think it's really going to make us one of the premier broadcast teams in the ACHA.
I definitely agree. Tonight was my first time seeing the Sling Studio. It's nice, small, size of maybe a Wi-Fi router. It is also its own Wi-Fi router. Pretty cordless for the most part, three or four cords compared to what we used to have. You guys should have seen it. This is an incredible upgrade, so you gotta love that. And it looks like we are heading towards player introductions soon coming up.
Indeed, we are going to take a step away here for a minute as we'll get St. Louis and Bradley introduced here by PA announcer Mitch Kaminsky. We're gonna step aside and we'll be right back.
And now, let's meet
All right, it looks like it is just about time to play some hockey here at the Owen Center. The Bradley Braves Division II team taking on the St. Louis Billikens. These two teams played last year right at the start of the season, and that one was in St. Louis. They're back, though, this time at Bradley. And last year was St. Louis coming out on top 2-0, Jack.
Well, you know, it's funny. That was last year at the beginning of the season. St. Louis actually swept the series with Bradley. But as the rest of the season went on, Bradley would finish 18-12-1 over 31 games, and St. Louis would only go 7-14-1 over 22 games. So St. Louis may have got the best of them early last year, but Bradley clearly had the better season. And we'll see how they can start out tonight, you know.
Going to be an important factor will be that start, which you talked about in our keys to the game. And I want to go over something, too, before we start the broadcast. The team you may notice is wearing a little bit different jerseys in terms of numbers and names. That turns out the jerseys that they ordered for this year are not in yet. And so they're going to have players wearing different numbers. So that's why it may seem confusing if you're seeing different numbers. But we will make sure to give you the correct players as we are officially underway here at the Owen Center in Peoria. The D2 home opener is officially underway as St. Louis gets ready to play it back behind the goal. That's Max Fidel with it for the Billikens. Fidel now making a breakout pass up ahead for Liam Knobb, who makes a big hit at center ice and picked up again here by Max Fidel. St. Louis getting a little physical early on here to begin this contest. Luke Fairchild with a quick shot, turned aside by Sule, no problem. This one up in the air, being batted down by Brooks Blackburn. And it'll be attempted to be cleared, but St. Louis doing a good job keeping that one. A little bit of a knuckleballer there that went wide of Sule. So we played up the right wing side now as the Braves come in. Brennan Peters dumping that one deep, and most of that first line will come off and get a chain. Big hit there in the corner. That'll get the students going early.
That's your keys to the game right there. Get physical, get the crowd pumped up.
This one coming to the boards, the physical play ramping up here early on for both teams, as it'll be Josh Crandall picking it up for the Braves. Crandall into the zone with a shot. That one didn't get through the traffic in front of the goal. Also in there for the Braves, Logan Nigg. Here's a chance out in front, and Spence with a dig. Loose in front and clear to the corner by that St. Louis defense. This one will go all the way back down for Sam Luches, and it will be an icing here. And a good physical tone set early here by both teams, Jack.
Absolutely. That big hit got the crowd into it. It's got the team into it. After that hit, Bradley had one or two good chances there early. Like we said, this is all on Kestner here, the inexperience on his side, and Bradley's got to keep peppering the net. We're about just 1.5 minutes into this game so far, and they're already getting it going with getting shots on net.
Tuttle can't win the draw for the Braves, so this will be the Billikens who have it down in their own end as Tuttle will force it back the other way. Back to the other side it goes in there for St. Louis. Patrick Waterman, the freshman for the Billikens. Go back up the board, and Waterman able to get it out momentarily. And Luches will play this one off the boards for the Braves. Nice pass up ahead for Seth Bishop, who takes a nice hit along the boards. Bishop, of course, we saw last year one half of that terrific duo with Elman on the D3 team, but he's moving up to D2. This one over the top. Nice slap shot attempt, but well wide by Patrick Pence. And the Braves reverse the other way. Seth Bishop with a shot well wide of the net as it'll be played over on the other side. Dumped into the other side there by Cam Etchison and picked off at center by Brooks Blackburn, who will dump it right back in, delayed off sides. And the Braves will tag up. Billikens trying to break this one out of their own end here. We're about 3 minutes in to the D2 home opener here, as Sule will just let this one roll on and he'll bump it to a defenseman. Billikens trying to play this one into the zone. Max Fidel taking a beating there from Blackburn, but they're offside.
Well, as you mentioned, last whistle, the physicality is starting to pick up, and St. Louis has gotten back at him a little bit. There's a nice hit up against the board towards the camera side here earlier. We still got plenty of time. This is a feeling out process. You know, we're less than 3 minutes into the start of this game. But like you said, very physical, very early.
Faceoff will be on that blue line, just outside the blue line, rather, of Sule's side of the ice. And it looks like it's going to be Brennan Peters taking the draw for the Braves as he'll win it back. And Brooks Blackburn will move it up the ice here for the Braves. This one tipped in off the stick of Brennan Peters. St. Louis defenseman Will Jackson, also another freshman on this Billikens team, getting in there for St. Louis. Back to the point it comes for Blackburn with the shot. Turn aside. No problem by the goaltender, Kessner. Back in behind for St. Louis, Will Jackson, and it looks like we're going to have a penalty coming up here. It's going to be a trip, our first penalty of the game. And it looks like, from the early indication, this one's going to be against the Braves.
Tough break there for the Braves. Just first penalty of the season and the game.
Oh, nope. I stand corrected. This one's going against St. Louis. It's going to be Dylan Kelly that sits for two.
Dylan Kelly gets two for tripping there and completely reversed around. Good break for the Braves. 3 minutes into the season, you get your first power play. They would love to go one for one to start the year.
Faceoff, of course, in the offensive zone after the penalty as the Braves will play it back. Cole Harris sending that one around for Kyle Tintera. This was the line that played really well against Illinois State on Thursday as they control it. Tintera back to the point. Brooks Blackburn over for Tintera. Back down low it comes. And reversing back up to the point. Blackburn again with it as he plays catch. Nice little move there by Peters. Back to Blackburn. Blackburn with the shot through traffic. And they score! It trickled through. And the Braves strike on the power play. It's 1-0.
There you go. That's exactly what you wanted. Just 30 seconds into the power play, the Braves score a goal there. They are up 1-0 with 16:29 left to go in the first. That was Blackburn on the shot, but I think that might have been tipped off by someone screening in front of the net.
There was all kinds of bodies in front of that net, and it'll be very important to see who gets that goal. Well, as soon as we get the clarification, we will let you know.
And that's exactly what you want to do with the Braves. You got to keep Pepper and Kessner all night long. More of those could come your way.
So back underway, the Braves strike first thanks to a power play goal. And it's a big one, giving them that early 1-0 lead. Back to 5-on-5, of course, now after the power play expires as the Braves come through center. This one being chopped at by Logan Nigg, and it'll be played back down low. After it for St. Louis, Charlie West, and flipping that one up through center, it'll be played by the Braves' Josh Crandall. So it is going to be Cole Harris that gets the goal for the Braves. A big one. Of course, 1-0 now as St. Louis possesses it in their own end. Charlie West making a play that was intercepted there by Bradley Sam Luchess, one of the newcomers on this D2 squad. This one thrown in deep there by Wes Straker for the Braves. Big hit there by Logan Nigg in the corner. Nigg digging at it in his feet, but it'll be played by Tuttle. Big hit there in the corner. It'll be sent back to the other side. Up along the boards for St. Louis, Patrick Waterman whacking at it there. And this one thrown off a few gloves. This will roll right to the Bradley defense in front of the scorer's table. And that will go out of play for a stoppage. 15:10 to go in period number one.
Let's go back to that Bradley goal there. We ended up realizing it was Cole Harris who got the tip in front. And, you know, kind of poetic, Cole Harris returning after last year being Bradley's leading point scorer with 32 points in 31 games. So he averaged just about a point a game last year, and he tacks one on to start off this 2019-2020 season.
This one dumped into the zone here by the Braves. That was Seth Bishop. And we mentioned Bishop playing D3. He was, no question, one of the top two players on that team along with Matt Elman. It'll be interesting how he adjusts to the D2 level compared to that D3 level as the Braves continue to chop away right in front of Kessner as it comes to the other side. Trevor Cooney whacking at it there for the Braves in the corner, but this will be picked up by the Billikens as they look to exit. Kept at the line. Nice pass over, just a little bit out of the reach there of Bishop. This one will go back up to the point and dumped in by Sam Bryant. Back behind the net, it's Jeffrey Au with it now. And so bump it over to a teammate. Official had to get out of the way there to let that play continue on. Long stretch ice pass, just a little bit too far out of the reach of the teammate he was looking for, and it'll go back down for an icing against St. Louis.
We talked a little bit ago about Cole Harris returning for the Braves. St. Louis getting the big return of their own. Luke Fairchild, that's number 14 in blue tonight. He was their leading scorer last year, 28 points in 22 games, and he is on the ice tonight. So both teams getting their leading scorers back. Should be interesting to watch as this game goes on.
Offensive zone faceoff here for the Braves. Cam Etchison on the draw. Unable to fully gain possession, so St. Louis trying to inch their way out. Good physical play, though, by Andrew Schmidt, keeping that puck in the zone. Billikens having possession again of it here as Schmidt makes a nice play in the corner. Now finally grabbed by the Billikens. This time Patrick Pence in it there. Patrick Pence, a senior, listed at 5'9", 200 pounds, out of the St. Louis, Missouri, one of the hometown kids. They've got a lot of them here on this St. Louis Billikens team. About 13, 16 or so here to go in this first period of play. 1-0 lead for the Bradley Braves. Tintera now with it in the skates, trying to get it out. Being whacked at right at the top of the circle. And now thrown back by Patrick Waterman. Nice pass out in front, just a little bit too far out of the reach there. And so it'll come back to St. Louis territory. At the line now, Jackson Jones gets hit hard by Kyle Tintera. A couple more Billikens get hit there. That time it was Charlie West. Braves looking to move up ice. Good seal-off job there by St. Louis. With it now, Josh Crandall for the Braves. Up in front of the scorer's table, this one dumped in. Soule will just let this one go back behind the net as we're under 13 minutes to play here in the first. Been a good one so far. Braves with a power play goal, though, from Cole Harris. That's the difference maker. And St. Louis got away with an interference penalty there. Refs will let it play on. And big hit again. Loose puck picked up by Spence with a drive right into the midsection. And we get the stoppage of play.
Stoppage play there, 12:29 to go. So we're about 8 minutes into this period, this game for the season. And
we'll take a look at this play developing here a little bit slower than I anticipated.
There we go, the new replay system.
Just giving it a test, and you see Spence with the nice opportunity there for the Braves as we are back to the action live here, kept in at the point by Josh Crandall. Lost it, though, and so the Braves will have to regroup as St. Louis grabs possession. Trevor Cooney into the zone for Bradley. 12:13 to go in this opening period. Another thing we're going to look to add here, Jack, at some point during the season is some sort of clock so that the viewers can stay updated.
That'd be nice.
In terms of time. Bradley across the line now. Cole Harris takes a big hit along the wall. And this one will be moved out of there by St. Louis. Kelly after it. And Kelly will finally throw it back down. St. Louis's forward line will come off for a change. Back behind the net, Sam Bryant, one of the newcomers with it now for the Braves. Bryant across the line. This will go back behind the net. Bryant, lucky bounce out in front. Tuttle trying to pull the trigger. Didn't get much on that shot. Braves momentarily keeping possession, and now here's a chance the other way for St. Louis. Fairchild with the shot. Soule the save, and the rebound comes sliding back up to the point. Big save there by Soule. That's probably his biggest one so far. Bishop creates a play at center ice. Here come the Braves. The shot on goal, and that one stopped for the whistle.
That play we just saw there, shot from Fairchild, and the rebound back out. That's St. Louis's biggest play of the game so far. Let's see if we can give them any momentum. Because as of right now, it's been all Braves. I feel like controlling the pace of the game, controlling in their in the opposing team's zone. But that right there, that was the biggest chance of the game for St. Louis. But Soule comes up big with a nice save.
That was Trevor Cooney with the shot on goal for the Braves as this one will be played up along center ice by Nick Corker for St. Louis. Braves struggling a little bit here in their own end, but Sorrentino able to find that loose puck and move it forward. Sorrentino into the zone. It's bumped off the puck, thrown out in front. Tuttle trying to reach his twig out to grab that one, or rather Jack Powerwavon as he sends it deep. Powerwavon, one of the seniors on this team, returning to the Braves for another season. Was a big part in their defense last year, and Jack, they're going to look to lean on him again, no question.
Oh, absolutely, for sure. They're going to really have to look to lean on this defensive core. While the offense last year, it's there, but like I said, this team, like the leading scorer, he's averaging just about a point a game. The offense can go cold every now and then, but this defense was a big reason they stayed in a lot of close games last year.
This one flipped up over the glove of Brooks Blackburn, so it'll come out through center, and Jack Powerwavon will corral it for the Braves. And it'll be thrown back in momentarily, and Powerwavon grabs a hold of it again here. We're just about halfway through this first period. Looks like about 10:10 to go on this clock. Up in the air, and this one will go into the netting, out of play right in front of those rowdy Bradley students there.
A nice souvenir there for a fan. He's excited. Oh, he's pumping up the crowd. And he's going to give the puck back. Class act right there. As you said, 10:26 to go. We're about halfway through. I'd say this is about where the feeling out process kind of ends. Like I said last whistle, the Braves had control, but St. Louis coming off a nice chance. They got a face-off in the Braves zone. They're going to want to capitalize here on something.
This one will be taken by the Braves here right off the draws. They've got that speedy line out. Look at Cole Harris diving his way into the zone, but just lost the handle. And luckily for Kessner, He was right there to play it to the corner. St. Louis now trying to desperately get this one out. Crandall had it for a moment, and now it'll be played out by St. Louis. Here they come. Patrick Waterman for the Billikens, backhanding it on. And a nice little play for Sule, able to make the stop.
It's a nice little floating puck right there to Sule. Good save by him, but on the other end of the ice for Kessner, he's been kept busy over there, whether it's Braves surrounding the net, just trying to tap in little pucks on the side. He's had to stay on his toes so far, and St. Louis is looking to keep Sule busy, but as of right now, Kessner holding his team in this at just 1-0 halfway through the first.
This one will be thrown around to the other side. Logan Nigg there for Bradley as he plays it up ahead. The intended target, Wes Straker. Spence, Straker, and Nigg making up that line out there on offense for the Braves. As Nigg takes a beating in the corner there. Straker in there to help. Straker, for those that don't know, was a former member of the Peoria Mustangs, who we also work very closely with. This one taken by Luchess, and Braves are going to have to tag up here on the offside. And Kessner looks like he's just going to hang on for the whistle.
That was a late whistle there. So the ref almost wanted Kessner to pass back out. He said no. Like we said, Kessner's had to keep staying busy. That was just a puck thrown in from the blue line, but it gets a funny bounce, and Kessner's still on his toes. This faceoff is going to come back outside the St. Louis zone here with just about 9:30 left to play in the first.
So this will be Sam Bryant for the Braves passing it over as they look to enter the offensive zone once more, but taken away, and Bryant's going to have to get back on his horse here. Into the zone, across the line, St. Louis comes. Great job by Bryant sealing that St. Louis offender, off along the boards. Braves will play it now along the wall. Seth Bishop able to tap this one out, but lost it in the skates there. The intended target was Trevor Cooney. Thrown along the boards and dumped in, but an offsides here for St. Louis. 8:56 to go in period number one at the Owen Center.
Going back to Luke Fairchild, I said earlier, leading scorer for St. Louis last year. We saw him set up probably their best chance of the game. He's a speedy guy, standing at 5'9", 155 pounds. For reference, that's about my size, and there's a reason I'm a commentator and not a hockey player, Matt, but he's got the speed and the skill. And that's what's gonna make him their leading scorer last year and potentially again a key player for them this year, as we've seen so far tonight on that big chance earlier.
Etchison will play it back behind the goal for the Braves. Again, stuck in their own end here momentarily. Sorrentino's attempted clear didn't work that time. So Brooks Blackburn will have to go play it as it'll come up along the boards for the Braves. Giveaway here as it's bounced right off the boards and back down below as Jack Parravan possesses it for the Braves. 1-0 your score in this game so far. The only goal coming from Cole Harris on the power play. And that's where we stand. This one into the scores table. Nice catch there, it looked like, in the Bronx from Taylor Zabrocki, who's working the scorers table. When the opportunity presents itself, you just got to grab it and you get yourself a souvenir at least for a minute before you have to give it back to the referee.
It's a good grab there by her.
8:12 to go, period number one here at the Owen Center. Been a good one so far. Braves leading St. Louis 1-0, trying to pick up their first win here of the season. Into the zone of goals for Cole Harris. Harris throwing it out front, sticked away, no problem from Kessner. To the point it comes, pad save. Kessner had to fight it off on the shot from Crandall. Along the boards it comes again. Digging in there for the Braves, Sam Bryant, who has looked good, or rather that time it's Sam Luchess. Bryant and Luchess, 65 and 66, both Sams for the Braves. Thrown right into the pads of Kessner, and we get another stoppage here with 7:40.
We don't have an official count right now, but Kessner saves just in the first half of this first period alone. Already get up there. They're keeping him busy. One thing I'm noticing is a lot of pucks are floating around his crease. If the Braves get a little more net front's presence, try to tap those in, kind of like how they came across their first goal tonight. You want to get more guys surrounding that crease.
Face-off here in the offensive zone for the Braves. This one played back down low, but will go into the netting out of play, so we'll redo things here.
Right back here. One thing I've noticed ever since that Braves goal the past couple minutes, a lot of out-of-play pucks, a lot of stoppages here, kind of slowing down the pace of this game a little bit. As of right now, I can't tell you who that favors. You got to think St. Louis, since Bradley was controlling the pace in the first half.
This one will be taken by the Braves back behind the net. Logan Ink got taken down, perhaps wanting a penalty but won't get one. Play to the corner here by Corey Kohut, another one of the newcomers on this Division II team for the Braves. Hit up along the wall, and this one will be played by Al. Now back down low, Logan Nigg trying to track it down once again, getting physical, back along behind the net, but the Braves able to keep it as Kohut has it at the point. Bounced off some bodies and flipped out of there finally, or it looked like it momentarily, and now Fidel will bat this one down. And a penalty coming up here against the Braves. Knew that one was going to be called, no question. And so the Braves are going to go on the penalty kill here. Looks like it's going to be a slash, and the Braves have their first penalty kill chance of the game.
Yeah, right there. That's Sam Bryant right there heading to the box on a slash. Like you said, we saw that one coming. Nothing you can do about that. But now this is the first time this season the Braves can get their penalty kill unit out there. This is a big test for them. I'd say first penalty kill of the season. They're hoping this one goes the opposite of the way their power play went. They want to try to stop St. Louis from scoring here, and we'll see how it goes.
We will have a nice little power play graphic that will pop up on the screen starting in the second period. So having some technical difficulties with that right now, but if we get penalties in the second and third period, we'll be sure to mark those up there on the board so that the viewers are aware. St. Louis with a chance. Here's a shot, and Sule able to shut it down. That's his best one of the night.
Sule right there, you said, just making his best save of the night. That's number 22 in blue, Max Fadel with the shot. Just waited just a little too long, gave Sule a chance to get over and make the incredible save. So St. Louis back to the drawing board and the faceoff circle with just about 1:37 left to go in this on this power play, 6:29 left to go in the period.
Boy, I'll tell you what, I would not want to be trying to shoot on to Sule with all those rowdy Bradley students there.
Absolutely
in the corner.
Not, up against the glass. You can't see him from the angle right now, but I'm sure when the camera zooms out, you will. That's so, the home side right there.
St. Louis again on the power play here, as this time it's Max Fidel with his shot that went wide of the goal. And last year we saw this at the home opener too, where lots of students crowded at the corner as the West can't hold it there. He'll have to regroup and send it right back in. But the referees do not like it, I know, when these students bang on the glass, and got to be careful not to get yelled at, because otherwise there can be a penalty assessed against the home team if the refs think the fans are getting too rowdy. So yeah, definitely something to keep an eye on too as we move along. Nick Corker into the zone now for St. Louis, dropping it back for Au as they'll go back to Corker behind the goal. 52 seconds left on the power play for St. Louis. As this one's tipped out of there, here's a break for Spence, but won't be able to corral it, but a good job on the stick work there. Across the line it comes, Nick Corker on the right side with a shot through traffic that's blocked. Thrown out in front again off the skate of Blackburn, and swatted out of there by the Braves. Good job by Logan Nick getting the job done for Bradley. Now across the line, Corker has it as he attempted to pass that one over to Liam Knob, but slapped right back in there, way off sides. So they'll have to regroup. 20 seconds to go on the power play as it's fired in deep once again. Back around the other way. This one will be played at the point by Au, who gets hit hard there in the corner by Brooks Blackburn. And all kinds of St. Louis players flying all over the ice here as we continue along in period number one.
It's going to end the power play for St. Louis. Good penalty kill by the Braves. First penalty kill of the season on the first power play for the opposing team.
Penalty coming up here against St. Louis. So Sule will come to the bench once it's clear. And this is going to be a trip against St. Louis. Not sure if we're going to be able to catch this one at center. Let's see if we can get it here on replay.
It's a tough break
right
for
there. I don't know if you caught that tail end of it, but Bradley player went down. That's when the ref put his arms up. And this one's going to go against Dylan Kelly for the trip.
So another tripping penalty. The Braves are 1-for-1 so far on the power play, looking to make it 2-for-2. Tough break if you're St. Louis here. You just got off, couldn't score on your power play, had a couple good chances, and now, right as it gets back to even strength, now you're down. And like I said, this has to feed momentum towards Bradley, right? They just killed off a penalty. They're excited. They're at home, and now they get another power play, which is how they scored their first goal of the game.
They've already scored one, as you mentioned right there, so this could be an important factor as we continue to move along here in period number two, or period number one rather, power play number two though, of course, for the Bradley Braves. Into the corner it goes, back behind the net, Will Jackson taking a beating. And now it'll go from West to Power Wave on at the point for the Braves. Spence has it along the boards for Bradley. Thrown out in front. He was looking for the back door there. Corey Kohut, the intended target. And the Braves will have to go back into their own end to regroup here. Kohut has it along the boards and will fling it back to the other side. Now out the center. Braves will come into the zone. Here's Power Wave on with it now. Wave on, throwing it out front right off the stick of Sorrentino. And again, St. Louis able to clear. I think, Jack, you can notice they made some significant improvements from their last penalty kill.
Oh, for sure. We're about halfway through this penalty kill. And St. Louis, well, they haven't let up a goal yet for one, but definitely some improvements. The Braves have been having to go back and chase the puck more often. So that's a good job from the Billikens there.
Tintera missed his shot wide of the goal to go back down for the corner where the Braves will play it. And now back up to the point. Here's the shot through traffic. Brock blocked in front by Tintera, but kept in by Power Wave on. Nice job by Power Wave on there as it comes back up to the point. Over from Luchess. Here's the shot. That one very close to the top of the net there as it's batted down by the Billikens. Back up to the point it comes. Here's Luchess with the shot. Tipped wide. Again off the stick of an own Brave. That time it was Brennan Peters. Luchess at the point again. Throwing it down low, this time intercepted, and St. Louis will clear it. Nice job, though, by Sam Luchess to knock it down with the high stick. 12 seconds to go. Look at the speed from Luchess across the line. Dancing his way in, but he's bumped off the puck, and it'll be thrown back out by the Billikens. That'll pretty much do it. A much better job on the penalty kill by St. Louis as they keep this game 1-0.
Much needed penalty kill for St. Louis, like you said, with just about 2.5 minutes left to go in the first period. Anything can happen. But that's a huge pick-me-up for them after letting up an early power play goal in the first period earlier this game.
This one will go the length of the ice. Sule will elect to play it as he'll drop it back for Brooks Blackburn. And it'll be thrown all the way up to the point, but not out. Good job by the Billikens to keep. Dancing his way in, a handoff pass there from Dylan Kelly. Thrown out in front again, and again, that Braves defense doing a good job clearing pucks out of the net there. Seth Bishop takes a big hit as he entered the zone. Slapped in. This one gloved down by number 28. That's Cam Etchison for the Braves. Thrown back in deep. Bradley getting their speedy line here out on the ice. Now the Billikens able to flip this one up. Corker across the line. It comes for Liam Knobb. Now bumped off the puck, and Sule lost it for a minute. Luckily, though, it was going wide. Thrown back in deep by the Billikens again. Max Fidel. Sule will drop it off. So we're winding down this first period of play. 1:29 to go at the Owens Center. 1-0 lead for the Braves. Here's Fidel into the zone, being bumped off the puck by Bryant. Fidel picking it up. Drop pass in front. Sule, I think that one caught a piece of the post there. And now thrown back down the length of the ice with 1:10 to go in the first.
Well, if that was the case, Sule stanking the post right there. But good effort by him to get over and make sure there's no room for that puck to get in. As we get another icing on St. Louis with 1:03 left to go in the first. Faceoff's coming back to the Billikens zone. And while there's a minute left, anything can happen in hockey. But I'd say this first period, it's gone mostly the Braves' way. But the Billikens got that nice penalty kill to keep this game where it's at. We'll see how this first period closes out. Like we said, 1:03 left to go. It's 1-0 Braves over the Pelicans. Or Billikens, my bad.
These two teams will be back in action tomorrow afternoon. We're slated for about 1:15 puck drop. And we will have that game here for you on the YouTube channel as well. So hope you can join us for tomorrow's game as well. It should be another good contest. Braves will play this one back in deep. Physical play back into the corner. Braves trying to get this one out. 37 on the clock as Power Wavon's waiting, and we get a stoppage here. And I think we might have a penalty. Looks like a cross check coming up here against the Braves. Let's see if we can catch this one on replay. Well, both teams were whacking at it, and
yeah,
I think this one's going to go against the Braves, but I think you really could have called it against either team there, Jack.
Yeah, a lot of guys over there. Tough angle here with our cameras. But that's two penalties apiece now for each team. The Braves have capitalized on one power play. This is the second power play for St. Louis. If they don't convert on it in these 33 seconds left in the first, they'll get it for about a little over 1:30 to start off the second. And if you're the Braves, that's what you want because you want to kill off this penalty. So that's going to be cross-checking, you said, right there. And now the face-off to the right of Sule.
Two-minute power play for St. Louis, as you mentioned. Fairchild will throw this one back behind for Patrick Pence. 26 seconds to go in the period. St. Louis trying to even this game up before we head to the intermission. Billikens with it again. Quick pass across intended for Corker. Goes wide. Corker thrown out in front. Up in the air, and Sule will let this one go behind him. 13 seconds as Straker gets the penalty for the Braves. Thrown down 7 seconds to go in the period. This will pretty much do it unless St. Louis has one last rush. Looks like they'll just kill the time for the first period as this one comes to an end after one period of play. We've got the Bradley Braves 1 and the St. Louis Billikens nothing. Jack, pretty good period overall for Bradley, but I think if you're St. Louis, you definitely improved as that period went on.
For sure. St. Louis, they let up the early goal in the power play, but now they've gotten two power plays of their own. They're in the middle of one. There's 1:27 left to go on that power play for St. Louis to start the period. This is what's interesting about these power plays that cross over into periods. It's like getting a really long timeout. They have plenty of time in the locker room to draw up some good plays for the man advantage, and they're going to try to even this game up. So right now, Bradley had most of the momentum. They got the lead. They're at a little bit of a momentum disadvantage coming into the second, but I say if they kill off that penalty, the momentum shifts back to the Braves to start off the second.
It should be a good second period. We're going to take a break for the intermission. After one period, it's Bradley 1, St. Louis nothing. Thanks for joining us on the Bradley Hockey YouTube channel. We'll be back for period number 2. Back here at the Owen Center, it's time for period number two between the Bradley Braves and the St. Louis Billikens. 1-0 lead for the Braves after that first period. And Jack, I got to say, looked like a pretty impressive period for the Bradley Braves.
It definitely was. Like I said, this penalty they got though, at the end of the period, that cross-checking in the corner, could have gone either way, but it went in favor of St. Louis. Now St. Louis had the ultimate opportunity. Still plenty of time, just about three-fourths of their time in the power play, 1:27 left. They had that whole intermission to make up a game plan here and try to even this game. So it'll be really interesting to see what they do on the power play here. Bradley 1-for-1 on the PK so far, though, so we'll see.
Only goal of this game came at the 16:29 mark of the first period, and that being time remaining. And that was from – it was Cole Harris from Kyleton Terrace, so that's the – only goal of the game so far. Braves leading it 1-0 as St. Louis has a power play to begin, and Soule makes a nice glove stop.
Nice glove by Soule right off the bat here, just a couple seconds into the period. 1:05 left in that power play for St. Louis. And now St. Louis, a plus side for them, like we mentioned earlier, the fans are all in that one corner, but the Nets have switched for the period, so now when they're in the Bradley zone on offense, they don't have to deal with all those rowdy Braves fans banging against the glass. We'll see if that has any factor. Sometimes it's the little things, you know. We'll see if that has any factor for St. Louis here in the second on the power play.
That's going to be an important factor, no question about it, as they continue to work here on this power play. This one's sent down by the Braves. And so there's 51 seconds remaining on that St. Louis power play as they regroup in their own end. Just getting underway here, period number two at the Owen Center. Been a good one so far, 1-0 Bradley leading St. Louis. This will not be an icing as it's beaten out. Patrick Pence trying to throw it in front, and now it'll go for Nick Corker. Corker banking this one off the boards as he will play it here for St. Louis. Now back to the point it comes, Fairchild across. Here's the shot rolling around. Soule able to make the stick save. And Harris continuing to dig away for the Braves as they kill off some more of that penalty time. 16 seconds to go on that power play. St. Louis has it again. Here's a shot on goal. Soule turns it aside. 8 seconds to go on the power play now. Back to the point it comes. Fairchild with it for the Billikens. Shot on goal, stopped by Soule. Able to make another save, and once again, the Braves have killed off that St. Louis penalty, as now they're finally able to at least momentarily move it up to the point, and now they'll continue to work at it. Looked like they were gonna get it out there for a second, but they don't. Good job by St. Louis. They're keeping that puck in the zone here. Now Knob will send this around the other way for Pence. Braves desperately need to get it out, and they do. This is a exhausted penalty kill unit out on the ice right now. And Power Wavon will move it forward for Bradley. Brennan Peters lost it in the wickets. Power Wavon still working with him. Peters now on the backhand, throwing that one in front, saved by Kessner. This will go back up to the point once again where it's played by Josh Crandall. Shot on goal, just trickled right through the crease. Now thrown out again. Off the skates of Crandall, picked up by the Braves on the backhand, and once again sent to the corner. David Tuttle working there for the Braves. Big hit, getting knocked off the puck there was Logan Nigg. Pinching to make the play, but unable to do so was Peters. Now thrown around back the other way. Into the zone here, Seth Bishop got tripped up, no call for the Braves. Into the corner as well as Trevor Cooney. Here's a pass out across, Bishop the intended target. Crandall poking at it there. And a big hit by him as he was not happy about that play. Braves throwing it in deep, 17:08 to go in the second period, 1-0 still, as this one will be played back by Kessner. Soule gonna let this one go for an icing, and we finally get a stoppage here after a few moments without a whistle, and there is 16:48 to go here in period number two.
Well, I don't know if we can go back a couple seconds ago there and have that last chance. That was Cooney there, number 22 for the Braves. He just took a little too long to pass that across the crease. Could have potentially been another goal. Just, again, a little slow reaction. This is the first game of the season. You're feeling things out. Pass was too slow, and Kessner was able to make the save.
This one kept in by Kohut at the point as he tried to send it across, but intercepted by Jackson Jones, who will fire it down the length of the ice. This will not be an icing against the Billikens, so they will change up all but that one player in the corner. Coming across now to the boards. The other side working there for the Braves, Cam Etchison. And this one sticked away by Soule. And St. Louis making another quick change in front of the bench there. And it looks like they've only got, oh, I missed one in the corner. Thought there was four players, but that was number 12, Dylan Kelly, hiding in the corner there for the Billikens. Now back up to the point for Au, trickling in front, blocked. Nice job there by the Braves. Back behind the net, it'll come. Backhanded, at least attempted to. Good job by Nig in front, reversing it back to the boards the other way. Up it comes. Fidel will fire this one across. Kelly had it, and he'll send it down low for Callahan.
Dylan Kelly looked like he completely lost sight of the puck there in that corner. He had no idea where it was. Now this one.
This is going to be an icing here against the Braves. 15:47 to go in period number two. Again, a reminder that we're going to have game number two of this series tomorrow afternoon, about 1:15 start time here at the Owen Center. And should be another good contest. Looking forward to it. We're going to have John Collin and Cameron Irwin on the call for that game. So looking forward to having them on board. Face off here, right off the draw. This one sailed over the top. Look out, Sule had to cover the post as Fairchild had a quick shot. And it looks like we're going to get a face off out of the zone here.
Quick whistle blown there. Once again, Sule very quick to get over. I think both teams, like I said, first game of the season, somewhat, not necessarily a sluggish start, but the timing's just a little off. A lot of these cross-crease passes and shots could be quicker, but Sule gets over quick enough, makes another great save to start off this second period.
Billikens have it again. Fairchild trying to throw it in front. Another try. Sule able to just fight it off, and he's just going to wisely hang on to this one here.
You mentioned Fairchild's name again. We were talking earlier, leading scorer last year for St. Louis. He said speedy guy. He's been all over the place. We've mentioned his name a lot tonight. He's trying to make waves out there in the Braves zone, just get his team kickstarted, trying to tie this game up, because this game may be 1-0 on the scoreboard, but right now this game could still go either way. We have over a period and a half of hockey left to play.
This one goes deflecting out of play. That was an original shot there. It looked like from the point. Whoops, we'll go ahead and get to a full speed replay, but that was Will Jackson who had that shot, and then it got tipped out of play by the Billikens. So it looks like we're going to have a face-off out of the zone. Officials discussing where to put it. And we'll see what they say here. 15:25, though, to go in the second. And it does look like it will be another offensive zone face-off for the Billikens.
To the left of Sule. There we are.
So here we go. Off the draw. Braves win it. Brooks Blackburn taking a hold of it here for Bradley. Some physical play back behind the net. Power wave on getting involved, but now the Braves have a real rush developing here. A 3-on-2 as Straker will play it in the corner. Takes a big hit there as this one will come off. Straker getting pretty physical along with a couple of hits there in the corner. Now St. Louis comes across. Fairchild, but they're offside, so they'll have to tag up. Braves with a nice pass across off the stick of Nig. And a nice little one-touch move there from Fidel to get around the defender. The shot on goal, no problem for the goaltender, Sule, who hangs on for the whistle.
Good grab by Sule there. That's Max Fidel, number 22 in blue. Showing off the mitts there a little bit. Got around two Bradley defenders. That's some good deking on his end for St. Louis. His faceoff could be out to the left of Sule. With 14:46 to go in the second, the Bradley Braves lead the St. Louis Billikens 1-0.
Off the draw, Braves whacking at this one again. It was Crandall blocked in front, and ooh, that stung. Tintera limping as he blocked the shot, but now looks like he's good to go. Harris with a nice pass across. Brennan Peters got taken down. Tintera finds that puck and fires it back the other way. Here's a drive right in, loose puck in front, and able to fight it off was Kessner. A dangerous chance there for the Bradley Braves, but this game remains 1-0.
That was a good bounce there for the Braves. Puck came back out, a fantastic chance, but just wide, but a good bounce off the boards there. Braves trying to set up shop.
Tintera will chase after this one here. It'll go up along the right boards for Patrick Waterman, who continues to work with the big-bodied Cole Harris for the Braves. Now this one being flung back the other way. Nick Corker trying to get it out, but cannot do so. Under 14 minutes to play here now in period number two. Oh, my, big hit delivered there. You don't see a guy like Cole Harris go down like that often, but a nice hit.
Patrick Pence for St. Louis absolutely lays out Cole Harris. Big hit there as St. Louis trying to pick up some energy here.
This one just thrown on nets. And
can we get that hit again with this new replay system?
Let's see if we can get it. I don't know if we're going to be able to. It doesn't look like it, but nonetheless, you don't see Cole Harris go down very often like that. But no. As you mentioned, Patrick Pence, the senior, getting a big hit there for the Billikens.
Patrick Pence, he stands at just 5'9", but a hefty 200 pounds, 5'9". That's a big boy right there. He'll knock you down like he did right there to Cole Harris.
13-18 to go in the second. St. Louis winning the draw here off the faceoff in their own end. And this one will be thrown back by Bishop. St. Louis, though, quickly reversing back out. Rivakuka working there as Bradley Player went down, and now it'll be taken into the zone by Bryant. Here's Bryant with the shot. That one sailed wide. Picked up by the Braves. Trevor Cooney in there with David Tuttle working against, it looks like, Jackson for the Billikens. Chance goes awry there for the Braves. Jones working along the boards. Tuttle in there as well for Bradley. And now it'll come back to the point. This one over for Power Wave on. Here's the drive. Glove save. A rebound pushed to the corner by the goaltender, Kessner. Thrown back along to the other side. Good hustle there from Bryant to keep the puck into the zone. Tuttle throwing out front. Scores! Nice pass from Tuttle. And the Braves finish in front. It's 2-0.
Great pass by David Tuttle there to set up his man. The Braves now have 2-0 with 12:46 left to go in the second. See if we can get a replay of that. Oh, my. Nice backhanded pass from behind the net. They used to call that the office back in Wayne Gretzky's day, right behind the net there. David Tuttle with a fantastic setup.
Trevor Kuhn gets the goal for the Braves. It's 2-0, and that was a beautiful pass by Tuttle, no question about it. So he will get the primary assist on that goal, and it's a 2-0 lead for the Bradley Braves now, thanks to that goal from Cooney. Wouldn't have been possible, though, without that terrific setup from David Tuttle. Nice work, no question, across the board by the Braves there. This one now bouncing out through center. Power Wave on getting a hold of it. Now the Braves come the other way. Here's a shot on goal. No problem for Kessner. That one coming off the stick of Andrew Schmidt.
12:34 left to go here in the second. Braves lead the Billikens 2-0. And this crowd still hasn't come down yet from that goal. That was a fantastic put. That was a fantastic pass, fantastic play. It's only the first game of the season, but right now that has to be play of the year for the Braves in this very young 2019-2020 season.
Shot from Power Wavon was going over the top, but gloved anyways by Kessner. So Harris and Cooney with the two goals for the Bradley Braves as they lead it 2-0. As get a good look at the student section there in the corner. It's a packed house tonight for opening night. Every year it's a packed house, and we'd like to see this kind of turnout for every game.
This is nice. There's standing room only in here. There aren't enough seats to hold this place down.
12:23. Remaining in the second period. Braves continue to chop away at it here. And this one will go back to the other side for Sosin. Here come the Billikens the other way across the line. Jackson gets laid out. A big hit there. And Jackson went down hard.
Ooh.
Nig with a nice pass for Spence, but it just went off the tape there. And so it'll come back through center. Here come the Billikens across the line. Sosin got taken down. Penalty coming up here against the Braves.
Yeah, it's going to be Logan Nig right there. I believe that's a slash. He had his stick underneath his arm right there. Obvious penalty. So now, once again, this will be the third power play for St. Louis. They haven't been able to convert yet. Will this be the one?
This is going to be a big opportunity for them, as we mentioned earlier in the game. And as you mentioned, they have not yet scored in this game. Of course, neither on the power play, but going to be an important factor here in this one. So we'll see what they can get going here on this power play. It looks like it'll be Patrick Pence to take the draw. As the Braves have it off the draw, Crandall trying to work it out, and he does. That one fluttered right through the skates of Fairchild, so he'll have to regroup at center ice. Intercepted by the Braves and flung down the length of the ice. 1:43 to go on that St. Louis power play, as you see on your screen there. St. Louis trying to get it. It's taken away by Tintera. Here's a break for Tintera, and it's blocked in front. Good work by the defense. Tintera looking to make it 3-0. Still holding on to it here in the corner. He's just going to kill some time off this penalty. But nearly another goal for the Braves. Here comes St. Louis across the line now. Knob with the shot. Sailing it high over the top of the glove of Soule. Knob back to the point it goes. And a crossover for Fairchild. Fairchild with a drive, saved by Soule. able to fight it off. Now right on the side of the net, Sule able to stop it. A couple of really good chances there for St. Louis.
Absolutely. We said again, that's Luke Fairchild. I think that number nine in blue, Nick Corker, might have gotten a stick on that, but it's just a little wide. Either way, good heads up. Looks like Sule would have made the save either way, but it got tipped out of the way. And now St. Louis here. Tintera and the Braves were off to a great start on the penalty kill, but now St. Louis trying to set up shot with exactly 1 minute left on this power play for the Billikens.
Sule hasn't had to make a ton of saves tonight, but he's come up big when he's needed to, and St. Louis has yet to score. Here's a chance in front. West trying to go to the back door, and fanning on that attempt, I believe, was number 22, Max Fidel, and a huge break for the Braves as that one seems certain at going in, at least for a moment. 36 seconds to go on the penalty kill for the Braves as they continue to work here. Ryan Spence throwing this one back down. This will be taken by Charlie West. And 24 seconds now on that penalty kill. Big hit in the corner by Sorrentino. This one played up the boards. Au with it for the Billikens as he'll flip it deep. And there as well, Patrick Waterman. And nobody home at the point for St. Louis, so it'll go back into their own end. Fidel with it for the Billikens, tipping that one deep. Sule will just let this one go to the corner. 9:54 to go. We're about halfway through this hockey game here at the Owen Center. A 2-0 lead for the home team, the Bradley Braves. Power wave on with it now for Bradley. Banking this one high off the glass and out through center. Could be a chance here for Trevor Cooney looking for goal number two. Quickly, though, reversed. Here's a break for the Billikens, and Sule comes up big. A nice save from Sule on that attempt.
Like you said, he's faced a little less shots, but Sule has come up huge when needed right there on a short little breakaway. Sule soaks it up, his entire body. And this game stays a shutout for him and the Braves. You don't like to talk about that kind of stuff, but I just said it, so my bad.
Well, if he doesn't get one, I'm going to blame you.
We know exactly who to blame, yep.
Braves take it off the draw here. St. Louis now off of that penalty, so we'll get that graphic back on your screen here. Into the zone, Seth Bishop playing it for the Braves. Bishop back behind the net, so bank it up to the point. Here's Sam Luchess with it, throwing it back deep once again. So Braves continue to work. Bishop, and now nice glove down. Bishop slapping that one wide. That took some hand-eye coordination, and it almost worked out. Bishop whacking at it again as looks like number 94, Corey Kohut, also in there for the Braves. This will not be an icing as St. Louis grabs possession. Jones being pinned along the wall, thrown out in front of Sule, no problem for him. 8:42 to go in the second period. Braves working on a 2-0 lead here in this game. This one poked at for a minute. Now St. Louis grabs it. Here's Knob. Throwing that one wide, and I believe the net came off its moorings, it looks like.
That must have been a pretty hard shot right there, because that's something I could think of. Yeah. I don't know, Sule touched, but you saw that puck bounce off the just the side of the net there, and I guess the net must have moved enough for the ref to see something. He called it. So this faceoff's going to come out to the left of Sule. 8:28 left to go in the second period.
Billikens have an offensive draw, as you mentioned. Fairchild was on the draw there but couldn't win it, so Bradley takes possession up along that St. Louis bench, and now Bishop able to muscle his way out through center. Sorrentino's whacking at this one as well with one hand on the stick, freed it up for a teammate. Braves in front, thrown out there. The intended target was Schmidt again, and that one sent just wide on the backhand. Bradley working again here in the offensive zone, looking to make it 3-0. Back to the point. Here's the one-timer deflecting wide of the goal. Into the corner it goes now. Sorrentino working on it for the Braves. Got hit off the puck, and as this one will fly into the Bradley bench.
Watch out. That one almost hit a coach, I think, in the Bradley bench. Like I said, you got to be careful over there down in between the glass on the benches. These pucks come in flying. But so far, good awareness time for everybody who's not a player tonight.
You mentioned the coaches, and I'm sure a lot of fans out there already know this, but, of course, Brian Hamilton, the D3 coach last year, is taking over for J.P. Fitzgerald as the D2 head coach. So Hamilton's had a lot of coaching experience. He was with the Mustangs at one point. So good choice, no question, for
absolutely
this D2
a guy
program.
Who's been in the program for a couple of years. He knows the system. Had good success at D3 team, improved a lot last year. Now he's getting the call up to D2, and this will be his first season as head coach of the D2 Braves.
Power Wavon got tangled up. Here's Sintera with it. Sintera with the shot, and it's turned aside by Kessner. But now Power Wavon getting into it here at center ice with Liam Knob. And I think we're going to have some penalties here as Power Wavon took Knob's stick and threw it right away.
You were watching calling the play. I was watching this. This is right here in front of us. That was Liam Knob. He kind of just got caught up with Power Wavon on the ground there. Power Wavon took his stick and threw it. Knob was ready to drop the gloves, but Power Wavon headed off the box. He said, see ya. That's going to be the fourth penalty of the game for the Braves. And St. Louis, they're 0-3 so far on the power play. Will this be the one? We'll find out. 7:20 left to go in the second and a full 2 minutes on the power play here for the Billikens.
Well, Power Wavon led the team in penalty minutes last year. He had some discipline problems, no question. And now he's going to have to sit here for 2 minutes thanks to that. We'll see what we get. My guess is unsportsmanlike conduct, but we'll see here in just a minute from PA announcer Mitch Kaminsky. So St. Louis with their fourth power play here of this game, trying to finally strike here. Indeed, it is unsportsmanlike conduct. And look out, Sule had that one roll right in front of the crease. And it'll be played in the corner by Kelly. Across at the back door, and a great stick work there by Sorrentino to prevent that one from going into the net, and this one cleared back down.
Well, it's what I've been saying all game. Both these teams, St. Louis again, too slow to get that pass across the crease. There's been plenty of two-on-one, I guess you could say, chances, cross-crease chances. Just these passes aren't coming off quick enough. Gives Sule plenty of time to get over and make that save to keep his shutout. I'll say it again. Keep his shutout. No. I don't believe in superstitions.
You're testing the waters here tonight, Jack.
I don't believe in superstitions. I'll say it again.
1:23 to go on that power play here for the St. Louis Billikens. They trail in this game 2-0. Goal so far from Trevor Cooney, the most recent one. And Cole Harris had the first one for the Braves. A packed house. This really is standing room only here at the Owen Center. And you love to see that type of support from the Bradley students and the Bradley fans. And we appreciate all you tuning into our broadcast as well, wherever you may be watching. And we'll have game two of this series tomorrow afternoon here at the Owen Center. Sule flings this one up off the glass. Big drive. Sule had to get back in position there, taking that one as it was teed off there by Fairchild. Into the corner now for Corker. Braves trying to muscle this one out. St. Louis keeps. Here it comes. Back door again. Broken up in front. Good stick work by the Braves.
Now, penalty coming up here.
Yeah, looks like I think St. Louis is going to go for a rough. See if we can catch that one on a replay here. So the play comes right out in front of the net, and a little bit of pushing and shoving, and that back official in the corner there caught it right in front of the net.
Yeah, this will be Liam Knob, the guy who was messing around with Wavon earlier on the ground. He's in the penalty box now, too. We're going to get 42 seconds of 4-on-4 hockey, and the Braves will get just about a minute 18 of power play time.
I can already see Knob trying to get Wavon's attention
in the box over there.
So it'll be interesting to see those two in the box together, and we'll redo the faceoff here.
Logan Nigg lost a glove there for the faceoff. I don't know if I wasn't looking there. I was looking at the antics in the penalty box, but I don't know if maybe Charlie West, he's lined up with him, accidentally took it off, some push and shove in. Who knows?
You mentioned 40 seconds of 4-on-4 time here, so here's a shot that went wide from Corey Kohut. That was a big chance, and it went wide. This one off the glass, out of play. Roughing for Knob. And that one coming at 6:01 of the second period. The D3 team will be on the Bradley Hockey YouTube channel next weekend as they open up their home side of things against the Purdue Boilermakers on Friday night and then again Saturday afternoon. So looking forward to those games as well. And Nig just had his stick slashed
once
right
again,
out of his
hand. That's the second time. And now some talking there from Nick Corker. And, oh, a hand to the face.
Corker should be going here, no question. He slashed his stick, and then he gave him a nice fist
right to Ryan
to the face.
Spence. That's the second time it's happened to Logan Nigg. Ryan Spence, fist to the face. That's the fourth penalty of the game for St. Louis. And now the Braves are going to get a 4-on-3 power play for the next 28 seconds, and then a 5-on-3 with about, I got to do quick math here, but about a little over a minute left, let's say, 5-on-3 for them. And I was going to mention, this game, I've noticed the little things, the basketball whistles, very physical stuff happening in the faceoff circle. And, I mean, I'd consider this a rivalry here. St. Louis and Peoria are very close. They start the season against each other almost every year, and you're starting to see some of that rivalry come into play now just with a little bit left to play in the second.
Here's a chance. Kohut sends it high. A big shot from Corey Kohut, and the Braves continue to work here. Power play for 4-on-3 for 14 seconds. Kohut down low in front. Kohut pad save. Turned aside by Kessner and fired down the length of the ice.
It's a good save by Kessner there. And he better prepare himself because in just about right now it's 5-on-3 and the Braves are going to get ready to set up shop here on the two-man power play.
So power wave on across. Here's Tintera for the Braves. A big windup. Sailed it high and wide. Kyle Tintera with a nice drive, but it went wide. Braves making a change on defense, so this one will slip out. 1:04 of 5-on-3, and then they'll have about 10 seconds of 5-on-4 before we go back to even strength. Here's Blackburn all alone as the Braves change up here in front of their bench. Blackburn buying some time for his men on the ice. Going to the corner. Sorrentino trying to move down low. Back up for Blackburn. Here's Blackburn across and gets it back. Here's a one-timer pad save. Kessner just got a piece of it, and it'll go back to the point. Power wave on down low. Thrown out in front. Good defense in front by the Billikens as this one's pushed back for power wave on. Blackburn at the point on that right side. Power wave on at the top. Wave on. Going to bank it off the boards here for Blackburn. He'll slow things down here. 19 seconds left to 5-on-3. Down low it comes. Nice work by the Braves. Back door looking in front. Rolling around. Kessner loose. And this one's still up for grabs and finally blown dead by the officials. And now things are starting to get physical, and the fans love it here at the Owen Center.
Absolutely. We got some pushing and shoving. Kessner might even be drawn off there to someone. Doesn't look like anything's going to escalate yet. I can feel it in the air. I think something might before this period ends. But great heads-up play there by Kessner. It looks like the puck was just rolling around in his crease, which I was mentioning in the first period happening a lot. He saw it. He trapped it up. I don't know if that was on the side of the net or right in front of the line or what, but didn't go in for a goal. And Bradley now has 23 seconds left on that second power play, 9 seconds left in the original. So it'll be 5-on-3 here for about, if they can win the faceoff, get one more good shot off. You'd love to score and then have about 20 more seconds of power play time. It's unlikely, but anything can happen in the fine game of hockey. But 4:10 left to go in the second. Braves lead 2-0. If you're just joining us, this has been an action-packed game. 4 penalties apiece for each team. It's really picking up here in the second.
No question about it. And we do have a Bradley player in the box. Not sure who that is at the moment. But we have 2 in the box for St. Louis. It's a 5-on-3 for the Braves for 9 seconds. And then for about 12 seconds, they will have that 5-on-4 power play as the Braves win it back. Power wave on now with it as he gets it across for Blackburn. Power wave on again. Moving it down low. Good work by the Braves. Wave on up top. Shot was blocked. Good job in front by Patrick Pence. And now we go back to 5-on-4. Tintera now with it. Across. Nice play for Blackburn. 8 seconds left on the power play. Blackburn getting it across in the circle. And broken up. Blackburn, though, doing a good job between the wickets there to get that loose puck as it goes to the corner. All kinds of bodies in front of that sign in front of the Bradley bench, and now finally muscled out of there, and we finally go back to even strength.
That is a huge, huge penalty kill there. Basically 2 for St. Louis. They were on the 5-on-3 disadvantage. Kill them both off and keep this game at 2-0.
Power wave on. Now working it for the Braves. Roughing penalty there assessed to Bradley, but we continue to play 5-on-5. Coincidental miners. Here comes St. Louis into the zone. Backhander stopped by Soule. What a stop. That's his best of the night.
That was Nick Corker coming right out of the box, I believe, there. Just he'd been out on the ice for a little bit, showing some great speed, getting past the Braves defender, and Soule making a nice stop on the breakaway. And it seems like I haven't caused anything yet. Soule's still got it going. 2-0, 3:10 left to go in the second. He's on top of his game right now. That's exactly what you want to see in a season opener.
I've been talking to Soule throughout the week, and he told me that he's ready for this home opener, and it certainly seems like it here on the ice as well. He's done a terrific job so far in this one. Braves have it in their own end, trying to work it up the boards. Big hit there by Seth Bishop, and now it'll be played in across the line. David Tuttle for the Braves, pushing it back down low. 2:43 to go in the period. Tuttle having possession at least momentarily. Now the Braves pick it up. Thrown out in front at the back door. That was Bishop trying to bury it for Bradley. Back in front of the net again, and St. Louis able to turn the tide back the other way. Thrown back deep off the stick of Joseph Callahan. And now Bradley one will now flip this up for Bishop. Lost it on the handle as it'll go back down low, back behind that red line. Tuttle in there, had it momentarily, back to the point. Shot there, hit the side of the net, and picked up by the Braves as they finally bank this one off the glove of Jackson. Here's Bishop trying to get to that loose puck, might have a chance, and it's loose, and Corker will cover it in the faceoff circle.
Kessner kind of just slowly waddling his way out there, but that was Bishop who came flying in, looking to capitalize on any chance he could get. We're just at about a two-minute warning here. 2:06 left to go in the second. Braves lead 2-0. But, wow, right now, I mean, St. Louis killed off those penalties, but Bradley right now, they got the hustle right now in there. I mean, flew down the left side of the ice, caught Kessner off guard, almost taps him past him.
This one will be held on to by Kessner again, but you mentioned that this team is speedy, and Seth Bishop last year, one of the things I noticed with that D3 team was that Bishop, far and away the fastest skater on that team, and he's looking like he's one of the fastest on this D2 group as well.
He's definitely shown it here tonight, and that's something you want. You want a good mix of size and speed and skill, and I think Bradley's D2 team this year, improving off of last year hopefully, that is something they got.
1:55 remaining in period number two. Goals by Cole Harris and Trevor Cooney for the Bradley Braves. Cooney's goal an even strength one, and Harris says a power play goal. Been a good one so far. We thank you for joining us here on the Bradley Hockey YouTube channel. We're looking forward to another great season of Braves hockey. The D3 team will open up next weekend against the Purdue Boilermakers. Looking forward to that one. Hope you can join it for us as well. Back behind the net, St. Louis playing this one. It's West who flips it out of play, 1:47. A lot of whistles here, Jack.
Yeah, this is starting to give me some flashbacks to the end of the first period. Maybe that's just kind of how it goes. The period's winding down. Players know that you're getting a little tired. You want that intermission break, but you got to grind it out. But a lot of pucks up into the benches and the nets. But that's what happens in very back-and-forth hockey games like this.
Kohut lunging to try and keep it in, and somehow that puck stayed in at least for the moment. All kinds of digging in front of that blue line there. And the Braves break free. Sorrentino able to force it back down low. And now St. Louis will muscle this one out of there. Or at least I thought that's what would happen. And now it finally does sneak through center. Just under 2 minutes to play here in this second period. A good one. 2-0 Braves. A goal in each period. Now picked up at the line by Krivokuka. As he'll play this one up along the boards. Nice work there by Bradley's Andrew Schmidt. Take down there at center, but somehow Braves still have it here. Schmidt fighting it off was Kessner, and we hit the 1 minute mark now in the second period.
Well, you notice there, two guys went down. Refs couldn't see anything really to call. Both guys went down. That's a good non-call by the refs there in a physical game like this. Let them play it out. Nothing too bad. Two guys just going at it. Both fall down. I think it's a really good non-call there by these referees. They're really picking up the vibe of what this game is delivering right now.
Power wave on into the zone, 38 seconds to go. Wave on with the shot on goal, blockered away. Played there momentarily. Nig went down, and no trip call. The intended pass out of the reach of Terrellin. As he'll play it back down behind the net. 24 seconds to go in the second period. Another big hit in the corner there.
It's about the third or fourth time. I've seen Nick's having it rough out there tonight. It's been a physical game, but they've been slashing him, chopping at his hands. He's had a tough time out there tonight, but he's a trooper, and he's going to stick it out.
Al with it, whacking at it for Bradley, or excuse me, for St. Louis, rather. Bradley has possession here. This will be thrown down the ice. A long attempt for Tintero, but he's going to run out of time here in period number two. Another good one for the Braves. They lead it 2-0 after the second period of play. Only goal in the period scored by Trevor Cooney for Bradley, and again, Jack, another good period for the Braves. They're certainly in the driver's seat here to begin the third.
Absolutely. You said another goal there. Cooney from Tuttle. We remind you that great pass. I mean, it's short competition, but that's probably play of the year so far through two periods. Tuttle setting up Cooney for the Braves to lead 2-0. And we go into this third, this game. Right now, Braves got the momentum, but St. Louis once again gets a chance. breathe it out, go in the locker room, make some game plans. It's a close game. It's physical. Someone's got to grab the edge here in the third, and it'll be interesting to see who that is.
It is going to be a fun finish. Bradley certainly hasn't put this game away yet. We've seen St. Louis with some good opportunities, as you mentioned. We're going to have a fun third period. We're going to take a break here for the second intermission, and we'll be back for period number three. Welcome back to the Owens Center in Peoria, Illinois. It's a 2-0 lead for the Bradley Braves after two periods of play here at the Owens Center alongside Jack Simzyk. I'm Matt Harrington. Jack, another good period for the Braves. Certainly some things to still work out, but St. Louis isn't out of this by any means. What do they have to do to get back in this game?
Oh, not at all. And like, if you're just watching or you're just joining us, as we know, this has been a physical game. Right now, scoreboard reads 2-0 Braves, but St. Louis's best chance here is they got to get the physicality edge. They got to get the clean, good hits in, get the Braves to make mistakes, get the Braves to make penalties. Each team's had 4 penalties so far. Braves have converted on 1 power play. St. Louis is 0-4 on the power play. You keep getting those opportunities. Eventually, you got to capitalize. I think if you're St. Louis, you got to frustrate the Braves here in the third. How they're going to do it, I'm not sure. Like I said, get some clean hits in. Get those sneaky little dirty – got to play a little dirty sometimes. Get the dirty stuff in. Slide under the rug. Make sure what the ref sees. Get some retaliation from the Braves. Ref sees that, like I said, in a close, chippy rivalry game like this, start the season. That's PA announcer Mitch Kaminsky pumping up the crowd right there.
Oh, yeah.
But in a game like this, it's never suggested not to go full dirty, but you got to get chippy. You got to get physical. I think that's what it's going to take for St. Louis to get themselves back in this one. They got 20 minutes to do it.
No question about it. Going to be a fun one indeed here as we'll get underway for period number 3, the Braves leading 2-0 in their home opener here against the St. Louis Billikens, trying to pick up win number 1 on the season. Into the zone they come. This one will be taken here by Trevor Cooney, one of the goal scorers for the Braves, thrown out in front, lunging to keep it in. It was the Braves, and they do so. Big hit, though, along the wall. That one almost gotten by Cooney, but instead Corey Kohut will have to track it down for Bradley here. This will play it in his own end. Nice pass up ahead for Tuttle, and the Braves will exit through center, but momentarily they'll have to hit the pause button and now resume. Across the line the Braves come. Losing it there was Kohut. St. Louis will reverse the other way. This one backhanded in deep by Fairchild. This one will just roll onto the stick of Soule for a stoppage of play.
19-11 still to play. We're just about 50 seconds into this period. And Soule adds on to his save total. Soule's been fantastic tonight for the Braves.
No question about it. Working on keeping that St. Louis goal total to 0. And we'll see what he can do here in period number 3 as the Braves have possession of this one, throwing it out way into center ice. This one will be picked up. And oh, my, big hit. That was Cam Etchison. Oh,
he's keeping him down, too. He's grabbing on him.
Yeah, Etchison went down really hard. And let's see if we can catch this on replay here.
Charlie West, he mashed him in the boards, and he held on, put him in a little headlock, held him against the board here. And that's going to draw a penalty. That's going to be a power play for the Braves.
Yeah, he gave him a little extra shove there. You might have been able to see that along that bottom right corner. And West will go to the box, assuming a rough or maybe a board even. So we'll get the official call on that. But nonetheless, a Bradley power play here.
The fifth one for the Braves. They're 1-for-4 so far.
So another chance for Bradley to make some moves here. Into the corner it goes now. Thrown out in front, save there. Blackburn digging away, loose puck. Whacked up by Peters. Now over to Tintera. He drives it, and that one missed. Loose in front and cleared down the length of the ice by the Billikens.
Brooks Blackburn's had some good looks tonight. He had that assist on the shot that was tipped in by Cole Harris to start the game. Another good look for him there. Blackburn's had some nice lasers to the net so far.
Bradley nearly making this one a 3-0 game here. They come across the line now. Cole Harris with a nice move. Harris with the shot, saved there from the goaltender Kessner, and it'll be fired down towards Soule.
Good chance there. Good chance there for Cole Harris. Driving his way and getting a shot to the left. That's a better save by Kessner.
This one dumped in by Blackburn, who will come off for a change, now into the corner. Braves looking to make some puck movement here back behind the goal. Up to the point, the one-timer from Kohut, loose in front of the goal and thrown wide as this will be played into the corner by Sam Luchess. Braves still have it, working on the power play, 49 to go. Back behind the net it goes. Up to the point, Kohut with the wrister, in front, loose puck. Harris off the crossbar. Harris with a nice try for the Braves, but we remain 2-0, thrown out in front again. And now a nice play there by the goaltender to glove that one. Had to reach down and grab it, but all kinds of chances for the Braves.
Absolutely. We've been talking a lot about Soule, but you can't overlook what Cole Kessner has done tonight. I mean, St. Louis, you could argue they're lucky the Braves only scored two. He's been fantastic in that. And like I said, only six games experience last year. He made a total of 40 saves among those six games. We don't have an official counter, but I think tonight he has to have at least 20.
At least, yeah. He's been phenomenal, as you mentioned, Jack. Keeping St. Louis alive in this game. They're lucky, really, to only be down by two. As this one will sneak out of the zone, it might be a chance for St. Louis. The power wave unable to grab that loose puck. A big break there for the Braves. Wavon will send this one off the back end of the net. Bradley's physical attack getting in 15 seconds on the power play left. Power Wavon will move this one down low as he takes a hit. And this will go through again, and Power Wavon get a stick slashed right out of his hands, and no call from the official. This one will be played up ahead by Spence, who took a big hit and gave up the puck as a result of it. And now St. Louis will enter into the zone.
I guess with how chippy this game's been, like I said, there's going to be a couple no calls there. And like I said, St. Louis has to get that physical edge. That's something they just got away with there. See if you can use that kind of thing to your advantage.
This one will be played here by Corker for the Billikens, trying to throw it out in front, bounced right back to the point. Here's Au throwing that one into the corner. Excuse me, into the corner, as it'll be played here by the Braves. Now with it is Au. Braves gain possession, 16-17 to go in period number three. Backhanded into the zone by St. Louis. Fidel will muscle it in deep. Braves regaining possession here. Long bank pass. This one's going to go too far for Seth Bishop. So we get an icing against the Braves.
They changed it, but it was exactly 16 minutes left. Now it's 5 o'clock, reads 15:59 to go here in the third. The Braves still find themselves up 2-0 on the Billikens. And this faceoff after the icing is going to come back into the Braves zone to the right of Soule, who again has been phenomenal tonight. He's got just under 16 left to go, keeping the Billikens at zero so far.
This one thrown on net, or rather off some sticks. The intended target, though, of course, the net, is Bishop lunged out to try and grab that one on the stick, but instead this will bounce right off the stick of number 9, Nick Corker, for the Billikens. Now Bradley finally able to get that breakout process going as Seth Bishop comes into the zone. Here's Bishop, good save. Rebound out in front, that's pucks loose. And to the corner it goes. Great defense by the Billikens. Bradley still hanging on to it here in the corner as Tuttle gets it over. Back behind the goal. Tuttle setting up out in front. And Kessner had to try and dig around there for a minute to find that loose puck, but he's got it.
Tuttle made that nice pass from behind the net earlier for that second goal, and you see him wandering, circling the net this game, and he almost had a chance to slip another one in. But Kessner is just doing everything he can for his team to keep it at two goals for the Braves. But right now the Braves, they have set up shop completely in St. Louis's zone the past couple seconds here.
Etchison off the draw. This one will be played to the corner by the Braves. Looked like Andrew Schmidt that time. Now Crandall halting the brakes here for the Braves. Schmidt able to muscle it into the zone. 15:08 to go in this period. A long glove attempt, nice play there by Etchison to get a hold of it, and now he'll fire it deep into the St. Louis zone. Howell back behind the net. Now up along the boards, Bradley continuing to work away here. Here's Schmidt, he'll just bump this one back to the point. Shot through Jarve, scores! Redirected in front of the goal, the Braves lead it 3-0.
Well, that looked like right there, a shot from Power Wavon again from the blue line, and that's another nice redirect goal for the Braves. They now take a 3-0 lead with 14:46 left to go. But you know what they say? It's three-goal lead, worst lead in hockey, they call it. We'll see what the Braves can do. But right now, Bradley's got a lot of momentum on their side. And that's a big one for them.
Bradley fans getting into it, and rightfully so. The Braves have added their third goal of the game. It's now a 3-0 lead for Bradley as we continue on play here, 14-14. And I got to say, with all the horns and cowbells, kind of sounds like a soccer match in here tonight.
Yeah, you know what? It's got a little bit of that vibe, but, I mean, they say soccer fans are one of the most passionate fans in sports.
Here's Cole Harris with a chance for Bradley, fighting it off. Kessner making the stop. Good chance But Harris just kind of ran out of room there, Jack.
Good save by Kessner there. And as we were saying, soccer fans are considered some of those passionate fans in sports. So that's good to say that Bradley fans tonight for this home opener are bringing the passion, and the team has paid them back for their efforts. A 3-0 lead here with just under 15 to go in the third. Things are looking good right now if you're the Bradley Braves.
This faceoff will be taken by Ryan Spence here for Bradley. Offensive zone draw. Here's Nig off the draw. Off a bounce. So Etchison gets the goal for Bradley. It's a big one. Fans are loving it. 3-0 lead here for the Braves at the Owen Center. Sorrentino getting one of the assists as well. Shot through traffic there. Sule able to track that one down with the blocker. A big save there. Here's a chance, and that one just missed the net. An off-balance shot there from the Billikens, but they're able to keep this one in the offensive zone. Knob with it, had it pickpocketed, and now the Braves come out the other way. This one dumped in by the dangerous Wes Straker. Haven't seen a lot of him tonight, but he continues to make a move here. Straker lost it, had an open man, and now St. Louis reverses the other way. Took a tumble there, lost his edge. That time was number 20, Brad Terrellin. And now St. Louis back through center. Nice moves by Fidel. And we're going to have a penalty here, I believe, against Bradley.
Yeah, it looks like it's going to be on Bradley there. And that's Braves now matching St. Louis with the fifth penalty of night. So a total of 10 penalties. And we still have over half the time here. 13:23 left to go in the third. And St. Louis, they just went down 3-0. This is their fifth power play of the game. They're 0-4. I think they need a score here. I'm going to say they need a score here.
So Nag is going to go for the hook. Not sure if you caught that on the replay, but just trying to go for the puck, and Nag got tangled up. So he'll go to the box for 2 minutes. 13:23 to go in this period, and St. Louis has another power play chance. It's a big one, trying to get this game back within striking distance. St. Louis now with the puck. And in the zone, great job defensively there. And I couldn't tell who that was. Looked like Straker, at least from up here, but a nice job to go down and prevent that puck from going any further.
I believe it was Tintera.
Yeah, you're correct, that is Tintera. Nice work by him. St. Louis in front, Sule able to hold on to it, and now we got some punches being thrown here in front of the net.
There we go, this game getting chippy. I thought there was going to be some action last period. We're starting to see it again here. Sule holds on for a nice save to keep his good night going here. And exactly 13 minutes left in the third, 1:37 left in the St. Louis power play. That puck was close. From our angle, I mean, you got to think it was just inches in front of the goal line, but Sule gets that mitt down on it.
1:37 to go on this power play here for the Billikens, who really, as you need it, Jack, need a goal here.
They do.
To try and get back in this game.
They absolutely need it here. This is a big chance for them. You're 0-4 on your power play. Get it going. Get that 3-1 lead. Or cut it to a 3-1 lead. My bad.
Power wave on now being pinned up along the far side boards right in front of that locker room number 6 here. You know, we're at a standstill. And now finally able to dig it out was Liam Nabu. The referee went down there for a moment.
Now referee goes down. It gets a decent reaction from the crowd, too. Interesting here.
This one will be grabbed a hold of by Fidel, who's got some nice speed across the line. Fidel dropping it back, and he'll get taken down. And again, Cole Harris laying it down. Big hit as Sule fights off that puck. Now flip back the other way. And this physicality has really elevated its game here in this third period.
That hit right in front of the bench, right in front of backup goaltender Devin Schneider. I saw him going crazy out there. It happened right in front of him. The physicality, there's been a good two or three hits here within the last couple seconds. It's hard to keep track of all of it.
38 seconds to go on the St. Louis power play as they continue to work here. Now this will be taken a hold of by Bradley's number 54, Ryan Spence, and cleared out of the zone with 26 to go on that penalty kill.
Another solid penalty kill so far for the Braves.
West has it for St. Louis. And it'll play this one up the boards, and that one went off a skate and somehow into the zone, but Bradley retains possession. They'll clear this one down with 10 seconds. That'll pretty much do it for St. Louis on this power play as West will play it up the boards.
The Braves have now killed off five penalties this game. They're 5 for 5 on the kill. It's a great way to start the season.
Physical play going on here back behind the plate. We're going to have penalties coming up here as that looks like it's Charlie West for St. Louis, and I'm not sure who that is for Bradley.
Yeah,
but
Charlie West got caught up in the leg lock around the head. That's Ryan Spence for Bradley, and you got to wonder if he'll go to the box for that. He had his legs wrapped around his neck.
So Spence going to go to the box here. And I'm not sure if we're going to get a penalty for St. Louis. Doesn't look like it.
Crowd's not happy. Sixth penalty of the game for Bradley. They're going to kill up another one here. And that, I don't know what that was. You put him in a wrestling move of sorts. But this is D2 hockey, not the WWE. So
well,
that's not allowed here.
If the hockey career doesn't work out for some of these players, they may be interested in pursuing a WWE career.
I mean, at this point, the way this game's been going, I wouldn't be surprised if somebody hit someone with a chair out there crying out loud.
So right now, Ryan Spence is the only one in the box for either side as you get a look here on your screen. So Spence in the box for the Braves. Right now they've got that sole penalty against Spence. We'll see if maybe we get another one.
And this is the sixth time of the night for St. Louis. They just saw it a couple minutes ago. This is the sixth time they're going to see this Bradley penalty kill unit. They got to have something. It's getting to me a little bit because this is a lot of chances. I mean, the Braves, do they have a good penalty kill? Yes. But if you're St. Louis down 3-0 in an important game like this where it's physical, momentum is both ways, you can score on one of these penalty kills. I want to see something from St. Louis here on this next power play.
This is a timeout, by the way, by St. Louis, in case you were wondering what the delay was. So they're going to talk, and definitely no question a good idea to call a timeout in this situation before you go on the power play.
Oh, for sure. And here we go. Bradley's fans getting riled up. Soule returns to his net. The team gets ready to kill off yet another penalty. 11:19 here left in the third. Full two-minute power play. Roughing.
Spence, as you mentioned, roughing. I was about to take the St. Louis power play graphic off because Bradley just killed one, but they have to do it all over again here.
I'm there.
With 11:18 to go in this game. Power wave on being met here in the corner. Braves trying to work it out, but kept in by Fidel, who we've seen put on a speed clinic here for the Billikens. Fidel with it across. Shot on goal. Soule fights it off. Loose puck. Batted away to the corner where Nick Corker has it. Back to the point it comes. Fairchild. He'll backhand this one around the other way for power wave on. And this will be soared across center ice right near that Mustangs logo. And St. Louis will regroup on this penalty kill, or power play rather, for the Billikens. And this one will go too far for an icing, so not a good spot when you ice it on your own power play.
Yeah,
and
absolutely
St. Louis
not.
Will have to defend.
And that was Fairchild there, who, like I said, rough night for him because he's had a lot of chances, but they've either just gone wide, been blocked, or Soule's deflected him away. This is their top scorer last year, like we said, but just you can see the frustration here building for him. Dumping it down for icing on your own power play. There's 1:19 left, but this puck has been taken back to the St. Louis zone to the left of Kessner.
St. Louis has it again. Max Fidel with it now. Fidel, a junior forward here, defenseman rather, for St. Louis, listed at 6'1", 180. Pretty good size on Fidel there, as he'll control the puck here again for the Billikens. Now this one played for Nick Corker on the right wing. Here comes St. Louis into the zone, and Knob got tripped up, picked up by the Billikens. Nice little pass over in front of the goal. Diving effort that time from Spence to keep it away from Soule. At the point, the shot sailing over the glove side. And back off the boards, 36 seconds to go. Thrown out in front again. Soule was ready, and this one will sneak past the stick of Fairchild.
25 seconds here left in the power play. St. Louis has one more good drive in them.
They'll break it out here again as they come across that blue line and now the red line back into the offensive zone. Power wave on a play here for the Braves and flung right back out of there with 7 seconds to go. That'll pretty much do it. Once again, another St. Louis power play comes and goes without a goal. And, Jack, I think they're certainly going to look back at this if they lose and say, you know what, should have capitalized on those chances.
It's 0-for-6 now for the Billikens.
Peters working along the line, able to muscle it in deep at least for a moment. Peters again working at it, banked off the boards, and Peters will drop it back off for Tintera. Billikens come the other way. Might be a break for Waterman. Here's Waterman, saved by Sule as he shuts him down on the breakaway.
That one sends the Bradley Braves fans into a frenzy. Sule with a great breakaway stop to keep this game at 3-0.
Intercepted by Blackburn. He'll fire it deep. About 8:41 to go. Tintera will play it in the corner. Now for Peters. Tintera back with it. Tintera flinging it back around the other way. Schmidt in there as well for the Braves. So lay a hit there in the corner and get it up toward West, and he'll fling this one out of play with 8:24 to go in period number three.
Yeah, as we were mentioning earlier, if you're the Billikens, you got to be kicking yourselves for all these missed chances. It's 0-6 on the penalty kill, and the Braves 1-5 on theirs, but at least they got a goal out of it. They're also up 3-0. So in desperate times, I believe the Billikens had three power plays this period alone. They haven't capitalized on any of them. You're down 3-0. And like you said, if this game stays the way it is and this is the final score, they'll definitely be kicking themselves in the locker room later tonight. But you know what? They got to come right back out tomorrow afternoon.
That game should start at about 1 o'clock or so. As again, an opportunity for St. Louis, but Waterman just couldn't grab the handle. Good defense in the physical play starting to ramp up here again in the corner. And again, these two teams will be back at it tomorrow afternoon. We'll have that one here for you on the Bradley Hockey YouTube channel. This one taken by Sam Luchess. The Braves will move it up through center ice. Nice little maneuver there. And slapped in. Good save by Kessner. A little bit of a knuckleballer, but he was able to fight it off into the corner there. All kinds of bodies being thrown around at the other side. Fidel with it now for the Billikens. And oh my, Fidel got laid out there. Looked like Corey Kohut was the one making that play. Loose puck picked up by the Braves. And they'll look to exit the zone as they do so successfully off the glass. This one off the stick there of Sam Luchess. And off the glass, that one nearly hitting the official. Thrown back around the other way. Billikens can't get it out off the stick of Terrellin. Terrellin maneuvering it back behind the net for Charlie West. West with a bank pass up ahead. The intended target there being Fairchild. Fairchild now moving it for Knob. Here's Knob right into the glove of Sule to get another stoppage of play here with under 7 minutes to go as power wave on, and looks like Fairchild exchanging some words back behind the goal.
Well, there's another save by Sule. It gets the crowd pumped here. Obviously, so is the physicality behind the net there, but Sule's been my player of the game so far.
He's been terrific. No question about it. Hasn't had to make a ton of saves, but he's made a couple of really big ones.
Especially in this third period. I think his third period save total is pretty up there now. We know, like I said, you can't overlook Kessner's had a good night. He's done what he can. He's let up three. But Kessner's had a great night, especially, like I said, inexperienced coming out here. But Sule, the experienced vet for the Braves, getting that call to start the first game of the year. He was ready.
Sule
again,
another one with a big stop right off the draw.
And these Braves fans are loving it.
They sure are. Let's get a look at this one right off the draw. And went to the point. West took the big slap shot, and Sule again ready for it right away.
Yeah.
So we'll do it again. 6:48 to go in the third. Sule able to fight off another quick shot. Back behind the net. Sule off balance. They score. Sule just wasn't quite ready for that one, and St. Louis is on the board. It's 3-1.
Yeah, that was Liam Knob for St. Louis. He's hit himself tonight. I think he's ended up in the box a couple times, been in some scrums. And there's a late goal there. 3-1. Braves still lead. 6:39 to go, though. 3-1 lead now. Another lead that's never safe, as we've learned in the history of sports. But we'll see if that'll do anything for St. Louis's momentum. If you're the Braves, you just got to make sure. You don't want to get too defensive and try to preserve the lead. You still want to attack, because the attack's been working all night long for them.
So St. Louis gets on the board. There goes that shutout for Sule. But nonetheless, he still had a fantastic game. Yes, trying to make the stop there and went wide. And the Braves will continue to work here. This one picked up at the point and flung back down low by Corker. Now West digging with Bishop at center. The Braves might have a break the other way. Bishop just lost the handle as West was able to get in on it there. Here's a chance for the Braves, tripped up there. No penalty, backdoor scores! Bishop buries it, the Braves strike right back. It's 4-1.
There we go, right there. Seth Bishop gets it right back for his boy Sule back there in net. And the Braves once again have a 3-goal lead. It is 4-1 with just a little over 6 minutes to go in the third.
How about that off-balance pass by Trevor Cooney, as you might have just saw there on your replay. He was on his knees and went back to the pass to get it across, and that was a tremendous play.
A fantastic play there. Lots of setting up in the net. That's fantastic. I just said fantastic twice. Don't know why, but 4-1. It's a fantastic game.
It was a fantastic play, no question, and a fantastic game as well, as that was a terrific play by Cooney, who's been looking really good in his Bradley Braves debut.
He's got a goal and an assist tonight.
Tintero working at it here, slapped out by Peters. Tintero trying to get it across the other side, thrown away, and now back down low to the corner. Chopped out of there, and Blackburn will retrieve it. This will be an icing against the Billikens. 4-1 lead, though. Knob getting that goal for the Billikens, and then Bishop getting the goal for the Braves.
They announced the goals right there, scores and assists. But 4-1 Braves, he's had a great setup from Cooney. And like I said, he's had a great debut here for the Braves. One goal, one assist.
Look out, Peters almost had it at the back door. Bishop getting a loud cheer, and rightfully so. He's going to be a big part of this D2 team like he was for D3 last year. And we'll see what he can do. That's his first goal. Already off to a good start for Seth Bishop. Braves now able to look at that pass. Here's a breakaway for Bradley. Backhander scores! What a pass, what a finish. And the Braves lead it 5-1.
5-1 with 5 minutes left, and that's got to be the dagger right there. A great pass leading to a great breakaway. Let's get a look at that.
Goodness.
Wow.
Silky smooth mitts by Kyle Tintera. Oh, my word. This game has had it all tonight. Wow, what a play. What a pass. What a goal.
And you got to absolutely love that. Bradley Braves, you couldn't ask for a better home opener.
No question about it. 5-1 now your score. And the Owen Center is rocking tonight. It's been a terrific night of hockey. And the Braves are in the driver's seat now, 5-1.
We got a standing crowd over here to the left by Sule.
Here's another chance for the Braves. Backdoor, looking in front, digging at it there with Sorrentino. Still loose, again on the backhand. And now pushed to the corner. Braves trying to work it back the other way. 5-1 lead for Bradley, a couple of goals after St. Louis made it 3-1. Look out again in front. Schmidt able to fight it off. Sorrentino back to the point. Shot scores! The Braves are on a roll. It's 6-1.
And that right there, they're in the middle of announcing the last goal, and I can't even hear myself in here. It's so loud. But 6-1 for the Braves. This game is all but over. Great home opener. Send them home. 4:30 left. And the Owen Center, like I've never seen it before, it is rocking in here.
My goodness, Bradley is just, all of a sudden, they made this game a blowout. This was a close game just a few minutes ago, and now it's 6-1.
Yeah, you know, I was talking some 3-0. St. Louis still has a chance, but now, wow, the Braves, this momentum is insane. And if this is what's a sign of things to come this season, oh my, the rest of the league better watch out.
So another goal for the Braves, and it's a big one. They make it 6-1. Down low to the corner it goes. Logan Nigg with it for Bradley, fighting off a defender there, and now bumped off the puck. Power wave on, pushing it to the corner. Braves working again here. At the point, Blackburn with it now. Throwing in front, loose puck. Nigg got knocked down in front. And now cleared out of there by the Billikens. Under 4 minutes now to play. Bradley maybe trying to tack on some more here for the big win. And there's some big hitting in front of that blue line there. This game has been turned upside down, really, with all the hits here. Logan Nigg getting in the action as well, too. Blackburn will go back to get this one. And 3:18 left, but Man, the Braves have been making a statement here these past few minutes, Jack. No question about it.
Absolutely. 6-1, 3:35 left to go in the third. On that last goal right there, Sorrentino with the assist. He's had a great night. Sorrentino's got two assists. Like you said, a great debut for Cooney. Cooney's got one goal, one assist, and then, again, a fantastic night from Sule. If you ask me, those are my three stars right there, but I don't make those decisions. But
well, if you did, I would totally agree with you.
Great night all around. Yeah. I mean, you might even want to include the fans. The fans showed up tonight. That's
absolutely. They have played a factor in this game.
100 stars out here.
No question.
Like we said, 3:35 to go, and now a power play for St. Louis, actually. That'll be Bradley's seventh penalty of the game. But St. Louis is 0-6 on the power play. A solid penalty kill tonight from the Braves, and we'll see if they can keep that going.
The fans singing, hey, hey, goodbye to St. Louis, as this one's pretty much all but over with 3:15. But St. Louis going to get a chance to work on their power play here. And we'll see what they can do.
I mean, it's goodbye for tonight. St. Louis is back tomorrow. They can always use these last couple minutes here. Get something going into tomorrow.
Sule had to fight that one off. Good work there in making the stop. This one will be played at center by Al. And now played back in deep for Josh Crandall. He'll leave this one off and get his return feedback. Look out! This one off the back end of the net there. Thrown out in front, and Brennan Peters right there to deliver it up ice. 3-on-3, Cole Harris, and they're offsides as he took a big hit there from West.
Nasty hit from West, too. Get ready for this one. Stands at 6'3", 235 pounds. He's the biggest player on the roster right here, so that's not pretty, but you know what? He withstood the hit. He checked him up in the boards, but he didn't fall down, the Braves player that got hit. He stayed up. 6-1 with about just a little over 3 minutes left, 3:03 left in the third. The Braves have just about closed this out. The fans, they're all standing here in the Owens Center for what has been a great home opener for this D2 Bradley Braves hockey season.
So it's a 10-minute misconduct to the Braves, but we still play 5-on-5. We'll get you updated on that as soon as we can about who that was. But nonetheless, St. Louis has possession here as they move up the ice. And it'll be a tip, so no icing as Kohut goes back to track it down. 2:18 to go here in the period. St. Louis continuing to work that one off a skate. And Schmidt playing it out here. And St. Louis will go back in their own end to track it down. Off the glass and off the skate there of Andrew Schmidt as he makes a big hit. Big physical play there by both teams. And now emerging free with that loose puck is Patrick Waterman. Waterman across the line. Sule able to fight that one off into the corner here and get it back. And this one going to go out of play with 2:09 to go.
Well, you said 10-minute misconduct for St. Louis. It sucks. There's only 2 minutes left in the game for them. But if you're the Billikens, you wish that carries over into tomorrow's game, but it doesn't. That's a reminder again. We will be back here tomorrow for game two of this series. St. Louis at the Owens Center taking on the Bradley Braves. And it looks like the Braves are going to head into that one with a nice 1-0 record.
Looked like it was Ryan Spence who got the 10-minute misconduct for the Braves, so he'll be sitting for the rest of this game. So St. Louis continuing to work here in the offensive zone. This one dumped into the corner and back around the other way. Just under 2 minutes to play here. Things are getting rowdy at the Owens Center. It's been a terrific night. It's lived up to all the hype that you could ask for. And they've had a terrific, terrific night here at the Owens Center. Lots of fans, a lot of Bradley students here. I mean, this has been, no question, a fantastic opening night, Jack.
Absolutely. Like I said, we've just been saying fantastic, terrific. All these words you're hearing, you know, there's no other way to describe it. This has been one of the coolest games I've ever gotten to call here at the Owens Center. This is just packed. This place is bumping. And the Braves delivered tonight on all the hype. Sule said he was ready. He's came out, had a great game, 6-1. And there's still a minute 30 left.
Bishop did not like the fact that he was getting bumped there by Fidel and could have maybe called an interference, but obviously letting it go. And now, hang on, things are getting chippy here. We've got a man down for St. Louis. Looked like he took a high stick. And let's see if we can get it. Ooh, oh, boy, here we go.
That's a little push from Nick Krivakuka there. I hope I said that right. Nick Krivakuka there for St. Louis, a little shove. And that was, that was number 17, Jeffrey Au. who's a little banged up there, slow to get to his feet. He's heading to the bench at his own will, so it looks like he'll be okay, but he's a little bent over.
Well, I was looking at that one on replay, and it was Wes Straker that looked like he went elbow first into the head of that St. Louis player, and that's something you don't want to see at all.
Yeah, that doesn't feel good.
Straker's going to sit the rest of this one out, and we'll see what we get here for St. Louis.
Looks like a little delay here. There's two guys in the box, one for each team. Some fans heading for the exits. I get it. Small parking lot. You want to head out early. But shout out to these fans here who are staying off for the finish of the game, showing their support for this team who, like I said, couldn't have delivered a better opening night to these fans.
No question about it. And we'll see what we get here in terms of penalties. Power Wave on. Looks like he's getting shown the exit here.
If my counting is correct, it looks like we're now at either 8 or 9 penalties for Bradley this game and 6 for St. Louis. But it's a mess at this point. So there's a 10-minute misconduct. There's penalties at the same time.
Power Wave on is going to get thrown out of this game. So not that it really matters with under 2 minutes, but
doesn't carry over into tomorrow, like I said. Power Wave on had a great night. He had an assist on that third goal to Etchison. But he's going to hit the showers early. I'm sure he'll be waiting back there to celebrate with his teammates. And it looks like a 5-minute major has gone up on the clock for Bradley.
So Straker is going to sit. Now, again, all these players will be getting out or done for the rest of the game. So we'll see what happens here. But we'll get some word here from the officials momentarily. One of the things, Jack, that we were looking at adding here at some point this season, probably won't be until about November or so, but we're looking at getting an ice mic so that we can hear the sounds a little bit better and maybe eavesdrop on the referees a little bit. I don't want to invade their privacy by any means.
An ice mic, I think it's for the betterment of the fans. We didn't have one of those tonight. Who knows what was being said out there? A lot of trash talking.
No, we want to make sure we're getting clean things on the
air. Yeah, you got an ice mic, you also got to get a bleeper or something to sense them out, because I guarantee you pretty things were not set on the ice tonight in this chippy contest. And they're still trying to figure it out here. Crowd's getting a little restless now. More people heading for the exits. We know Bradley's finished it off. They have this game won, but I don't know really. They're just trying to sort out penalties here. I think it's not going to affect the outcome of the game at this point.
No, not at all. And unfortunately, this is kind of what happens when you get a blowout like this where one team likes to get a little dirty and get out of the skin of the other team, and that's what we've seen here tonight.
I've called 12-1 blowouts before, and this is just what happens. It almost delays it a little bit. It kind of sucks the life out.
You've got nothing on my 17-0 blowout that I had of the Mustangs last year over Evansville.
Wow, so, that is.
Yeah, I don't think I'm going to have anything that ever tops that.
No, I'm almost glad I wasn't there for that. I love calling games. I'm glad I wasn't there for that one. I believe it's a Bradley D3 game against Milwaukee 2 seasons ago. Milwaukee won that one 12-1, and that was a long game, let me tell you.
So Straker going to be showing the exit here as well for the Braves.
All right.
Head contact in a game misconduct for Straker.
I mean, that's head contact. It's not safe right there. It's something in all sports nowadays you're watching out for with all this new information on CT and things like that. So a good call by the refs. Toss him for head contact.
St. Louis going to get a power play here for 3 minutes because they have that 5 minute and then another chance. Tatera across. Shot there. Loose in front. And a tremendous play by the goaltender to cover that one up.
Wouldn't that have been something? If on the penalty kill, just because Bradley attacks on another one, just for more salt in the wound. But Kessner, last season played 6 games, let up 23 goals. That's about five. That adds up for 5.10 goals against, and that was about what we had tonight. He's let up 6, so he was impressive the first 2 periods, but Kessner showing a little bit of his last year's self in this third period, and he's playing up to his stats pretty much from last season.
So faceoff is going to come out of the zone here, and 1:10 remains in this game. Again, a reminder that at about 1:10 tomorrow, we're going to be giving you a good look at these two teams again. It'll be round 2 from the own center. John Collin and Cameron Irwin will be on the call for that one.
That's a good duo right there.
Yes, sir. Rays, we're going to break this one out here now as they close out this game. Tintera across the line, grabs it, and he'll drop it back to the point. Big drive, turned aside, And Tintera controlling it again behind the net. Nice pass out in front off the backhand. Braves almost had it. That was Brooks Blackburn, it looked like, or rather Josh Crandall for Bradley. Thrown back behind the net. Tintera, loose puck, taking a hold of here by the Billikens. 32 seconds to go. As he's bumped off the puck, that was Nick Corker for St. Louis.
Just 20 seconds left here.
And St. Louis will hold on to this one. Will Jackson will grab it. 17 seconds to go. Braves trying to get one more on the board here. Sorrentino and Bishop. Here's Bishop. Not tangled up here. And he had all kinds of pressure on him. 2 seconds to go. 1 second. And that'll do it. The Bradley Braves finish off the St. Louis Billikens by a final score of 6-1. And the Bradley fans showed up
standing
and they got a good
ovation.
Treat.
Oh, absolutely. We said some great plays tonight, great goals. We said that second goal, Tuttle the assist to Cooney. Cooney tonight, one goal, one assist. Sorrentino, two assists. Sule letting up only one goal late in garbage time. But a 6-1 win for the Braves. Plenty of standout performances. Like I've said multiple times, I'll say it one more time before we go out there. You could not have asked for a better home opener.
You could really not have, Jack. It was a tremendous night of hockey. The Braves close out a 6-1 win. You mentioned all kinds of guys that had multi-point games for the Braves. And a chance for St. Louis to kind of soak this one in tonight. And they got to get right back at it tomorrow. They got a lot to fix.
Yeah, absolutely. Like I said, they're going to be kicking themselves for those missed opportunities. I believe the Braves had 8 or 9 penalties this game. And not a single power play goal for St. Louis. So they're going to be kicking themselves. But you know what? They have a chance to redeem themselves tomorrow. It's one game. St. Louis going into it 0-1, Braves going into it 1-0. You never know what could happen. I've seen weekend series like this where it's two complete opposite games. But
as of right now,
the Braves, fantastic game. They're going to start off this season with a perfect 1-0 and send this Owens Center crowd home happy.
They sure are. It was a terrific game. Thank you for tuning in here at the Owens Center as you get a salute from the Bradley team, a stick tap, and they deserved it, no question. As Sule gets the win in net tonight for the Braves. A terrific outing from him. And the final score again, the Bradley Braves 6, the St. Louis Billikens 1. These two teams will be back at it tomorrow afternoon at 1:10, and you can find that right here on the Bradley Hockey YouTube channel once again. So for Ryan Allgaier on camera and Jack Simzyk on color, I'm Matt Harrington signing off here from the Owens Center. Thanks for joining us, and we hope to see you tomorrow.